now at Masada Airfield, when the Elbit test site, when we are testing these days the final test of the Hermes 900 Starliner. It is a Category 3 UAV, also called MALE, which is a medium altitude, long endurance UAV. The only one in the world that has the civil certification to fly in the civilian airspace. It means that it was certified by a civilian aviation authority to fly in a civilian airspace. It is the first UAV to receive this very tough certification. It means that they have all the safety elements, starting from the design to the production, and also, of course, from the UAV systems integrated in order to enable him to fly in an unsegregated area, in area with other civilian aircrafts. It is the first UAV to be able to do so. The drone that you are seeing behind me, the Starliner, part of it is produced already in Romania. There is facilities of Elbit in Romania, in Bacău and in Bucharest, that are manufacturing electronic and mechanical parts for the UAV. We are using them for all of our UAVs that are manufactured and imported to all of our customers. We believe that in the next step for Romania, it might be a relevant platform. These days the Romanian is on a process of purchasing NATO Category 2 UAV up to 600 kilograms when we are proposing the Hermes Watchkeeper. This is the higher level, which is more than 1.5 ton UAV. The Romanian requirement at the moment is for NATO Class 2 UAVs, which are up to 600 kilograms. It's used mainly for tactical missions, for army missions, for navy missions. This UAV is category 3, which means for more strategic and operational level of missions. And we believe that for the next step, it can be very important development for the Romanian fleet. Both UAVs, the Hermes Starliner and the Hermes Watchkeeper, we are putting them under the family of Hermes. It means that there is also components and elements that are similar to all of the systems. We are talking about the concept of the ground control station. We are talking about the payloads. We are talking about the avionics part of it. There is also components that we took from the Hermes Watchkeeper and the Hermes 450, and we also use them in the Hermes Starliner and the Hermes 900. We are now preparing for flight. We call this stage a pre-flight stage that is testing all the relevant systems on the UAVs. It makes it very easy to get the situation of the UAV if it's ready for flight. The UAV will taxi to the runway. It has an automatic taxi. It will take off. Once the takeoff is taken, and it's an automatic takeoff and landing, it means that you don't need to have an external pilot. Usually, in UAV, you don't need to do nothing. Our agenda is to fly the UAV and be focused on the mission. He will focus on the mission, on the payloads that he is operating, on the area of interest, and the UAV will fly by himself. We are in the ground control station. Here are the operating consoles. Simultaneously, we can fly two UAVs.
Let's say, for example, I want the UAV to turn right 25 degrees rolling. I'm just pressing here. And now the UAV, as you can see, turning right 25 degrees. Because we are very, very close to the antenna on the ground, there is reflection of the signal. This is why you can see the picture always scrambling. Now we're flying only in this area of Metzada airfield, and flying is very, very simple. If I want the UAV to fly to this area, I'm just pressing right key, active FTC. FTC means flight to coordinate. I'm pressing flight, and here you can see a small circle. The plane is flying, and I can sit here with my hands, and the UAV will do everything I'm telling. I will take control from here. This is a stick. The stick it's not meant for flying. Okay, flying, mouse and keyboard. When I will do right, camera will do right, left, left. If I want to look down on the ground, down on the ground. Now I want to show you how much I can zoom in. Okay, we can see him here. It will be the same at day, at night. Okay. Sometimes it is easy to forget that we are flying a UAV because it's a camera. But if I will go to the right side, I will be able to see the right wing. Okay. Here in the Dead Sea, we can see in the back the propeller, the UAV itself.
Elbit assembly line, UAV assembly line and integration, where we are getting all the components of the UAV and assemble it. The remaining requirement is also to produce the UAV and to assemble it in on Romanian soil. So our intention is to build the same assembly line and integration line as you see here in Romania in order to enable us to build the Romanian systems. Another requirement is also to build the air vehicle parts in Romania. So we intend to build in Romanian companies the air vehicle parts, the fuselage, the wings, the tail. It will be produced in Romania. We are talking about composite material. We are dealing with the Roma Airways for the production of the air vehicle parts. We also have Aerostal for the assembly and integration, and we also have Elbit companies that already produce components of the UAV that you are seeing here. Harnesses, mechanical parts, and other elements that produced in Romania already. We, of course, will increase the amount of those components in order to meet the Romanian requirement. But we have companies in Bacău like AE Electronics and Elmet. We have Simultech in Mugărele. So we also have base companies that already proved their capability in Romania, and we of course during this plan going to extend these capabilities in order to meet all the requirements and build it in Romania as requested.